Hello friend, did you know your Debian 12 system also has an expiry date? Do not risk running out of support. In this video, I will show you the safest and the fastest way to upgrade to Debian 13, so you can unlock new features, better hardware support and 5 more years of rock solid stability. But if you are thinking that upgrading from Debian 12 to Debian 13 does not worth it, then let me tell you the key benefits you will get with Debian 13 over Debian 12. For the first time, Debian officially supports the RISC-V architecture, meaning now you can test or use Debian on a fully open source hardware. Using the Foronix test suite, it was found that Debian 13 shows an average performance improvement of 10 to 13% over Debian 12. Debian 13 features an upgrade from kernel 6.1 to 6.12, enhancing and optimizing performance for modern multi-core processors. Debian 13 includes newer versions of essential software such as GNU/C compiler 14.2, Python 3.13 and OpenJDK 21, which improves efficiency and compatibility. The default GNOME desktop environment is upgraded from version 43 to 48, along with all the other desktop environment, offering a more refined user experience. And as with all the previous releases, Debian 13 maintains the project's commitment to security enhancement and stability while integrating modern software trends. These improvements has already made Debian 13 a compelling upgrade choice for many users who are seeking better performance, enhanced features, and improved security. So, without wasting any time, let's future-proof your system as well. The upgrading process from Debian 12 to 13 stable release is generally very easy and straightforward. However, Debian's official documentation suggests that you should be informed about few key important details first, especially about the discontinued hardware architectures. Debian 13 has fully dropped support for x86 32-bit architecture, so pure 32-bit systems cannot do this upgrade. ARM 32-bit still works, but only with older Raspberry Pi models. And finally, MIPS architecture is gone completely. So, if you are on any of this architecture, you will have to switch your hardware. But if hardware is not an issue, then you have to follow few steps for the upgrade, which are majorly divided into these 4 categories. And you can start the upgrade process with the first step, that is update and cleanup. But before starting this whole process, let me show you my system specs using NeoFetch. So here you can see that I am using Debian 12 and my kernel version is 6.1. Therefore, the first thing you have to do is update your system to the latest point release and then clean up your system. To do this, you have to use the following command: sudo space apt space update space and space sudo space apt space upgrade space hyphen y space and space sudo space apt space auto remove space hyphen y space and space sudo space apt space clean and hit enter. The first two command will update your system to the latest. Then the last two will remove your system's unused packages, dependencies and cache files. Then after doing this, you have to continue with more cleanup process and check if there are any obsolete packages available on your system or not. using this command: apt space list space single inverted comma or apostrophe question mark obsolete again single inverted comma or apostrophe and hit enter. If the result returns with nothing like this, then you can proceed to the next step. But if it shows that obsolete packages are present in your system, just like I do, then you have to remove all of them before the actual system upgrade. To do that, you have to use the command sudo space apt space purge space single inverted comma question mark obsolete again single inverted comma or apostrophe and hit enter. This will remove all the obsolete packages from your system. You can re-verify if all the obsolete packages are gone or not using the previous command. Removing obsolete packages are very important because it may introduce complications during the upgrade process and can present security risk as they are no longer maintained. Then, if you have ever enabled the Debian backports facility on Debian 12, then you have to disable it as well. For that, you have to check if backports repo is enabled or not using this command: cat space forward slash etc forward slash apt forward slash sources dot list space pipe space grep space backports and hit enter. If the result returns with nothing, then you are all good to go. But if you see something like this, that means backports are enabled on your system and you have to disable it. For that, you just have to uncomment or comment out the backport source line in the sources.list file. I am using Nano Text Editor for this demonstration, but you can use any text editor to open the file and type sudo space nano space forward slash etc forward slash apt forward slash sources dot list and hit enter. This will open the sources.list file and you have to put a hash or a pound sign in front of the backports line, just like this. And this will disable the backports line, eventually disabling the backport service from Debian 12. And finally, if you have ever installed any non-Debian packages, then you have to remove them as well, which will complete our first step. Then the second step in our list is backup. Before upgrading from Debian 12 to 13, Debian strongly recommends that you make a full backup of your system using apps like TimeShift, or you at least backup any data, config file, or information that you cannot afford to lose. Debian officially mentions to backup these directories. As the upgrade process itself does not modify anything in the slash home directory, you can back it up there. Or else you can use an external hard drive or USB drive as well. For better segregation, I will suggest you to create a separate slash backup directory inside the slash home directory. And for backing up, use the following command: sudo space cp. CP stands for copy, then space hyphen r. R stands for recursive, meaning the copy function will copy the directory as well as the subdirectories. Then space slash etc space slash var slash lib slash dpkg space forward slash var slash lib slash apt space hyphen t. This means 2, meaning it is pointing to the destination directory. Space forward slash home forward slash username, in my case it will be NixNexus forward slash backup and hit enter. This backup process will usually be complete within 2 minutes. Then our third step will be editing the repository. Here you have to switch the Debian repository from Bookworm to Trixie by updating the sources.list file. For that, you have to open and edit the sources.list file. I will again use the nano text editor and the command sudo space nano space /etc/apt/sources.list and hit enter. Here, the goal is to replace all the words bookworm with Trixie. Just for clarification, the words which we are using here are the code names of different Debian versions. Bookworm is the code name of Debian 12, and Trixie is the code name of the present stable version, that is Debian 13. You can individually edit all the lines, but the quickest way to do this will be using the replace function. For that, you have to hit Ctrl+\. Then it will ask you to enter the word you want to search or replace. So you will write bookworm and then hit enter. Next, it will ask to enter the word that you want bookworm to be replaced with. So here you will have to enter Trixie and then press enter, following with A to replace all at once. Then you will have to enter Ctrl+O to save and Ctrl+X to exit. And our repo editing will be complete here. And finally, after this, you can now upgrade your system from Debian 12 to 13. For that, you have to open the terminal and run the following command to start the upgrade process. First, you should just update the repo with sudo /apt/update and hit enter. This will take 3 to 5 minutes depending on your internet speed. So let me speed it up. Okay, next. To minimize the risk of breaking the system during the early stages of the major version upgrade, Debian recommends to just upgrade the system with the minimal base install. And to do that, you have to use this command. Sudo /apt/upgrade /--without-new-pkgs, which stand for packages, and hit enter. This ensures all the current packages are updated without introducing new ones, thereby reducing the likelihood of dependency issues. And by the way, during this upgrade process, the installer might show you some manuals, which you can skip by using Ctrl+Q command. And it might also ask you about several services being restarted. So hit yes or no according to your preferences, after carefully reading the message. After this is done, you can now execute the full upgrade with sudo /apt/full-upgrade and hit enter. This full upgrade might take between 10 to 20 minutes depending on your internet speed. This will handle all the dependency changes, install new packages while completing the transition to the new release. Wait for the download and installation of packages, and after the upgrade is complete, use sudo /apt/modernize-sources to modernize the sources file, because Debian from version 13 onwards is transitioning to a newer, more structured format called deb822, which will be using .sources file instead of .list files. And when this is done, you can reboot your system with sudo /systemctl/reboot. And our upgrade is complete. So let me enter my user password. And here we are, in a newly upgraded Debian Trixie. Let's download FastFetch to check the system details. Here you can see our operating system is Debian 13 Trixie. Our desktop environment is GNOME 48. We are using Wayland. And our kernel version is 6.12, which is a long-term support kernel. So there you have it. I hope this video will make your Debian upgrade much easier. But if you still have any question or confusion, feel free to reach me in the comment section below. And if you have found this guide helpful, then check out my Debian 13 fresh installation guide or subscribe to the channel for more open source tips. See you in the next video. Until then, keep learning and keep using Linux.